Hello friends, welcome to Impulse Physio. Today's topic is pneumonectomy. To the ones who have yet not subscribed to my YouTube channel, please go and subscribe it and do like, share and comment. Today's topic is pneumonectomy, so let's get started. Pneumonectomy is defined as the surgical removal of an entire lung. Remember, entire lung, not a part of it, but an entire lung. When it is removed, it is referred to as pneumonectomy. Then there is a second thing, which is radical pneumonectomy. Radical pneumonectomy involves the removal of the lung along with the removal of the mediastinal glands with dissection through the chest wall or the pericardium. So whenever we approach the lung through the pericardium or the chest wall in order to remove the lung and plus the mediastinal glands, then it is referred to as a radical pneumonectomy. Now, what are the indications when we go for the this procedure? The very first one is carcinoma. When there is any cancer in the lung, at that moment we go for this procedure. See here, I can show you with the diagram. As you can see, in this lung there is a cancer, right? So we have removed the entire lung. As you can see in this picture, we have removed the entire lung, and this procedure is referred to as pneumonectomy. Second one is bronchiectasis. The third one is chronic tuberculosis. Fourth one is fungal infection. Now, what are the complications associated with this procedure? The complications associated with this is the damage to the nerves. Fenric nerve, when gets damaged, it leads to paralysis of the half of the diaphragm, therefore affecting your respiration. The second thing is recurrent laryngeal nerve. If you remember, recurrent laryngeal nerve is your part of your vagus nerve. When this gets affected, it leads to inappropriate approximation of the vocal cords and thereby impaired speech, respiration and coughing. Now, what is the incision we go for? The incision we go for is posterior lateral thoracotomy. Posterior lateral thoracotomy starts at the level of the third thoracic vertebra and follows the vertebral border of the scapula and the line of the 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th rib, extending forward to the anterior angle of the ribs. So I repeat once again, posterior lateral incision starts at the level of the third thoracic vertebra. So you are giving an incision at the third thoracic vertebra, and then you are extending the incision from the vertebral border of the scapula and then to the, and the line extends from the 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th rib to the anterior angle of the ribs. Now, preoperative physio. See, preoperative physio is very important. Whenever the patient is going for the operation, then this preoperative physio becomes very much essential. The followings are the aims. First one is to gain the patient confidence. Second one is to clear the lung fields. Third one is to teach the respiratory and the inspiratory holding. Fourth one is to teach the postural awareness. Fifth one is to teach mobility about the bed. Now, the patient confidence, see, this one is a very important thing. If you teach the confidence to the patient, it helps to allay some of his fears associated with the operation. Therefore, the patient becomes more confident, more encouraged and more cooperative. Now, the second one is clearing the lung fields. So you need to give shaking, vibrations, clapping techniques in order to remove the secretions. Huffing is taught to the patient. It is very important so that the patient post-operatively follows you more appropriately. Then the third one is patient must be taught to support the incision. So how are we going to teach the patient to support the incision? The arm on the affected side is moved and placed across the thorax, supporting the incision from below. Remember, this is very important. You should remember how to support the incision. Reinforcement is provided through the arms of affected side and hand fixes the opposite elbow. Now, We need to teach respiratory exercises. We will go for the inspiratory exercises. We'll be focusing on removing the secretions. Now the post-operative physio. See, post-operative physio is followed by your pre-operative physio. It's the continuation of your pre-operative physiotherapy. So first of all, you need to, whenever you move to the patient, first of all, you need to see whether the patient is on the oxygen therapy, whether the drains are in situ or not. So you have to administer all the things. You have to check for the notes, all the patient notes, patient history, patient incision site, everything, any other complication, BP, what are the medications he is taking, everything you need to administer. So if there is too much fluid, the mediastinum may be shifted towards the unaffected side. But if the fluid is less, then the mediastinum shifted towards the affected side due to overinflation of the sound lung. Now you must be wondering, ki agar hamara lung ek side ka humne remove kar diya hai, if we have removed one part of our entire lung, then that vacant space, the cavity, what is in that cavity? वो कैविटी किस चीज़ से, वो कैविटी क्या ऐसे ही वेकेंट रहती है? नो, इट गेट्स फिल्ड अप, इट गेट्स फिल्ड अप, द डायफ्राम गेट्स इन्फ्लेट, द जो हमारा दूसरा लंग रह गया होता है वो ओवर इन्फ्लेट हो जाता है. सो समहाउ वो स्पेस जो कि वो कैविटी बनाती है उस रिमूवल ऑफ द लंग के बाद, वो उसको फिल कर ही देता है, नॉट कम्प्लीटली बट अप टू अ सम एक्सटेंट. एनल्जेसिक्स अगर आपने दिए हैं पेशेंट को, अगर वो एनल्जीजिया पे है, तो यू नीड टू सी बेंजोइन टिंचर मे बी गिवन टू लूजन अप द सेक्रीशंस. देन देयर आर सर्टेन गोल्स टू प्रिवेंट वुंड कॉम्प्लिकेशंस, टू प्रिवेंट सर्कुलेटरी कॉम्प्लिकेशंस, टू अलो फुल एक्सपेंशन ऑफ द चेस्ट, टू मेंटेन गुड पॉस्चर, टू इनहेंस जर्नल मोबिलिटी. नाउ द डे ऑफ द ऑपरेशन, पेशेंट का ऑपरेशन हो चुका है, सेम डे पे वी आर सपोर्टिंग द पेशेंट इन हाफ लाइन विद ट्रंक नेक फुली सपोर्टेड विद द पिलोज. वी आर गोइंग फॉर द एंकल टो मूवमेंट्स, एंकल पंप मूवमेंट्स वी कैन से. व्हाट वी डू, हम डॉर्सी फ्लेक्शन एंड प्लांटर फ्लेक्शन पे फोकस करते हैं पैरों की. वी गो फॉर द एक्सपेंशन एक्सरसाइजेस फॉर ऑल एरियाज ऑफ द लंग्स, फॉर ऑल एरियाज ऑफ द लंग्स. विच एरिया ऑफ द लंग, जो बचा हुआ लंग है, जो हमारा सेकेंड लंग है जो हमने रिमूव नहीं किया है, उसकी हम एक्सपेंशन एक्सरसाइजेस करवाते हैं. डे वन पे वी गो फॉर द सेगमेंटल एक्सपेंशन एक्सरसाइजेस. शेकिंग क्लैपिंग वाइब्रेशंस आर अप्लाइड टू द साउंड लंग फॉर द रिमूवल ऑफ द सेक्रीशंस. सी, योर टेक्निक मस्ट बी वेरी एप्रोप्रिएट. इफ यू आर नॉट डिलीवरिंग this clapping, vibrations and shaking appropriately, then your secretions won't remove. So you need to give these techniques very effectively. Huffing and coughing techniques are taught. Maintenance of posture is focused. If you are not focusing on your posture, scoliosis can develop. Scoliosis is a postural deformity which can develop in patients with this. So scoliosis is another complication which you can add. Frequent short sessions are beneficial over long-term protocols. Arm movements such as hand touching opposite shoulder. So you need to tell the patient to touch his opposite shoulder. You need to tell the patient hand touching scapula from the behind, shoulder into full elevation. So you need to help the patient and properly guide him to achieve these activities. Then second day, patient is taught bilateral breathing exercises, sitting on the edge of the bed, and he will perform trunk twisting, trunk bending side to side. So all these activities you need to tell to the patient. Trunk stretching backwards. Why we are telling this stretching exercises to the patient? Because incision hua hai patient ko, right? So incision wali side ko zyada move nahi karega kyunki isko pain hoegi. Therefore wo shortening mein ja sakti hain, wo jo side hai wahan ke muscles jo hain wo shorten ho sakte hain, contractures can develop. So we need to give stretching protocol bhi humne apni post operative physiotherapy mein dalni hai. Patient moves around the bed with the bilateral arm swinging. Now the day 3 mein patient joins the group therapy. Group therapy is a technique where you make your patient do exercises with all other patients experiencing the same condition. This helps to achieve the patient's confidence. उसको ज़्यादा जल्दी बेटर करने में हेल्प करता है, रीइंफोर्स करता है उसको हर एक एक्टिविटी को जल्दी अचीव करने में. सो यू कैन से एक हेल्दी इंकरेजमेंट उसको मिलती है. एक्सरसाइज प्रोटोकॉल्स कंटिन्यूज द सेम एज अबव. नॉट डे फोर, पेशेंट इज ड्रेस्ड इन अ ड्रेस्ड एंड इज कंटिन्यूड फॉर द ट्रंक मोबिलिटी चेस्ट एक्सपेंशन एक्सरसाइजेस. अराउंड डे फाइव पेशेंट इज़ अलाउड टू मूव इन अ यूनिट. सो अब आपने उसको मूवमेंट करवाने शुरू हो गए हो, अराउंड द बेड मूव करवाओगे, ऐसे ऐसे उसकी मूवमेंट को बढ़ाओगे. सो यू आर गोइंग फ्रॉम सिंपलर टास्क टू द कॉम्प्लेक्स टास्क. नॉट डे सेवन, स्टिचेज आर रिमूव्ड, पेशेंट मूव अपवर्ड एंड डाउनवर्ड फ्रॉम स्टेयर्स. अराउंड 14th डे पेशेंट इज डिस्चार्ज विद स्ट्रिक्ट इंस्ट्रक्शंस फॉर मेंटेनिंग द थोरेसिक मोबिलिटी. सो यू नीड टू मेंटेन द थोरेसिक मोबिलिटी, दैट इज मस्ट पॉइंट यू नीड टू टेक केयर फॉर निमोनेक्टमी पेशेंट्स. नाउ मॉडिफिकेशन टू द ट्रीटमेंट. इफ द सिक्रीशंस आर एक्यूमुलेटेड इन द साउंड लंग, वाइब्रेशंस एंड शेकिंग आर नीड टू बी अप्लाइड, कीपिंग द पेशेंट लाइट टूवर्ड्स द ऑपरेटेड साइड. सो सी, आपने पेशेंट का लंग रिमूव जो है वो कर दिया है, उस साइड पे सिक्रीशंस जो ऑपोजिट साइड का लंग है, फॉर एग्जाम्पल दीज आर योर टू लंग्स, दीज आर योर टू लंग्स, यू हैव रिमूव योर वन लंग, राइट. सिक्रीशंस इस लंग में एक्यूमुलेट हो सकती हैं. सो आपने पेशेंट को जिस साइड पे ऑपरेशन हुआ है उस साइड पे लटाना है, सो दैट जो लंग इंटैक्ट लंग है आप उस पर अपनी टेक्निक्स अप्लाई कर सकें और सिक्रीशंस को रिमूव जो है कर सकें. Then tipping must not be performed for the risk of fistula. So fistula development is another complication which you can add. If the recurrent laryngeal nerve is paralyzed, secretions are removed by breathing exercises and cuffing. These are very important points. So you must focus on these. When the fenugreek nerve is damaged, IPPB, intermittent positive pressure breathing devices, is given to remove the secretions. If the amount of air entering into the remaining lung is insufficient, IPP may be provided with caution on lower pressure and only on prescription by the surgeon. So you need to give these devices only when surgeon had advised so, else you can't prescribe it. Humidification and oxygen therapy must be provided. Now there is another technique we go for, that is referred to as incentive spirometry. Incentive spirometry is indicated in patients who experience hypoventilation, right? Remember, hypoventilation. In cases may we give incentive spirometry due to high thoracic or abdominal surgery. So agar lung volume bahut zyada kam ho to spirometry, I guess आपको स्पायरोमेट्री पता है, आप एक अपने देखा होगा, एक ट्यूब सी होती है, उनमें तीन बॉल्स होती हैं. जब आप इंस्पायर करते हो, अगर आपका बहुत लंग वॉल्यूम बहुत कम है तो ओनली वन बॉल मूव्स अप, एंड इफ़ देर इज़ अ मिड लंग वॉल्यूम देन द सेकेंड बॉल राइजेज अप. इफ़ यू हैव अ फुल लंग वॉल्यूम, दैट्स अ वेरी ग्रेट कंडीशन, देन योर थर्ड बॉल्स ऑल्सो रेजेज अप. सो यू नीड टू गिव इंसेंटिव स्पायरोमेट्री टू द पेशेंट. If the patient holds inspiratory holding के time पे balls raised ही रहती हैं, तो हमने उसको inspiratory holding भी सिखानी है जिस time पे उसकी balls, तीनों के तीनों balls जो हैं वो raised रहेंगी. So these devices basically strengthen both your inspiratory and expiratory muscles. Therefore this topic is finished. इस टॉपिक के नोट्स आपको इंस्टाग्राम पेज पे मिल जाएंगे. So you can check my Instagram channel. The link is given in the description below. So stay tuned. Thank you.